She will represent Jamaica on the international stage. Lavina Bennett is a newly crowned Miss Universe Jamaica 2017, and she joins us. And that's ahead of our rain, because the crown is on your head now. Heavy is the head that wears a crown. Good morning to you.
Good morning.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Have you seen that footage, Mr. Footage, before?
Yes.
Okay.
All over social media.
And what do you feel when you look at it? And what was that on your face? That was like, was that my name?
Wait, I didn't know that I was the winner. Because I thought what they did, I didn't hear they say first run out. So I thought what they're going to do is crown the Miss Universe and then hand me the flower to walk off. So what is when I saw the crowd going, that's when I'm like, oh Jesus, it's me.
Oh yes, it was you. It was you. I first interviewed you here on Smile. Last week.
Yes.
Could have been Thursday. No, I wasn't here Thursday. Tuesday, maybe?
Friday morning.
There was something about you, even from that time, and I hear a lot of people saying it, that there was something about you that had the essence of Miss Universe Jamaica written all over you. I don't know how you take that now. I look at you, you still look like you're kind of soaking it in. What has that been like since Saturday?
Oh my gosh. It's two words. Instant fame.
Yeah.
My social media has gone up. There's so many persons that are reposting from even different countries. It's amazing.
From different countries already.
Yes. Even like Miss Brazil. We have persons from Colombia, Puerto Rico. There's so many countries that are tapping in and saying, you know, congratulations. And
well, it's going to get really hectic from here on out.
Oh, yes.
You get started already. You sleep from Saturday night?
That's just
kind of it. Tell me about your prep up to this point now. For the contest itself, I mean, I know you're involved in your foundation.
Mm-hmm.
You've been doing work with the deaf.
Mm-hmm.
And then you stepped into this. You've been modeling. So pageantry was kind of newish, but had an element of familiarity to it. How was it preparing to get to that point on Saturday night?
Well, a lot of gym time, a lot of long training, sleepless nights. There are times when I just felt like I wanted to give up. You know, you wake up in pain from gym. You couldn't eat every and everything. Well, I'm used to that from modeling. But it was a lot of hard work that I had to put in to get to where I was Saturday.
Yeah.
And truly, I've seen tremendous growth in myself. Because when I just started, I couldn't even, you know, get my T-stance. I was like, how am I going to even pull this off?
T-stance?
Yes.
Sorry, come on guys. I know you have to teach. What is a T-stance?
Remember when I showed you Friday?
No, I don't remember. Take up your dress.
Oh Lord, so much. So you have to, like this.
Oh, this one.
Yes,
ma'am. I thought T was like so.
No, ma'am. So you put it in front of this and you have to tilt. No, you know, look.
Let me now look.
Look.
This is not.
Okay. Right, and you have to hold that in.
No, but I feel that into my core.
Right, you feel it right in
the center. Oh, jeez, all right. Bad job. Okay. Alright, so obviously you had a T-stance.
Yes.
The question though, how nervous were you when that was asked? You said it.
I was very nervous. I asked everyone if when I got off stage, I was like, did I sound shaky or did you see the mic moving? Because I don't know if it was in my mind, but when I was there, this was me. But apparently no one else saw it.
Yeah.
So I guess that was in my mind. But that was when I got really, really nervous. But through the entire time, I was like, Davina, just finish, finish. Execute and finish.
Those of us who teach speech, we say nerves are natural. It's how you conquer it that makes it work, and you clearly conquered it. Because I didn't know you were nervous. You sounded very calm. What happens now? Because you've won the crown. You head off in November on the 26th?
Before the 26th, you have
to. The 26th is a competition.
Yes.
You're not sure where yet?
No.
Okay. But it get kind of ramp up from here.
It's a lot of hard work. I can't miss gym. That's number one. I have to be careful with
our... Do you like working out, Erica?
I do.
Okay.
I do. It's just, you know, some of the times, you know, you have to get up early.
Yeah.
or you know, you just can't be bothered some of the time. So it's a lot, you know, a lot of speech training. I have to get myself aware. So it's really a lot because Jamaica is expecting a lot.
That's my next question for you. Because I've seen social media myself.
It's going crazy. There
are a lot of people who are saying this girl is something special. We haven't seen something like this in a long time. No pressure. How does that make you feel?
I won't call it pressure. It's really an amazing feeling. Everybody's saying, you know, I'm dark skinned, I have natural hair, and they expect nothing better than just to win. So I'm going to do my best to execute and bring the crown home for Jamaica.
I was reading through your bio, and it says your most unusual experience is being held up at gunpoint.
Yes, I was.
When did that happen to you?
That happened March 3rd.
I was this year?
Yes, this year. I was on a photo shoot, and I got robbed. Everything was taken at gunpoint. Laid on the ground and everything taken, and I got, you know, a little bit set back in school because my laptop, books, everything was taken. But my life is somewhat like that, where these unexpected situations, you know, come up. I don't get things easy.
Yeah, but you obviously have
someone that is
overcome adversity.
Right.
Yeah,
that's me. This is why, you know, when I won, the reason why I was crying was because the only thing that was going through my head was that, you know, you finally won something. I've worked hard for many things in my life, and I would have it in my hand, and in seconds, it's gone. And I've never actually got to say, I've won.
Mm-hmm.
So it's really,
I think you've been winning and you just didn't know. Because when you can get past setbacks repeatedly, that means you're a winner. So yes, you have a crown now. Girl, you've been winning. it's clear. I see it in your smile, it's in your eyes, it's in your passion. It's just in the kind of, you know, what you exude. It's a qualitative thing, you know, you can't really put it into words.
Thank you.
But you just have it, whatever it is. So you now move forward.
Mm-hmm.
With the expectations of Jamaicans on your shoulders, but all the blessings in the world, I'm sure you've been getting some really great feedback.
Oh my gosh,
yeah.
Amazing. And in my little district, that's Micheltown, they made sure to tell me. Micheltown in Clarendon.
Please to tell them.
Yes, they made sure to tell me, called from this morning, please to mention our name. So Micheltown, thank you for all the wonderful comments. They were beating pot cover, you know,
of course, order. I mean, Aperture Square, Micheltown.
I got cars were blowing horns. It was like when Walter run.
What did you win?
Oh, pardon?
What did you win?
When I won my crown. And
yes.
So everybody was, you know.
I've been asked to ask you about the car. Did you get a car?
I'm not getting that car. I'm getting a newer car. Yes, that's launched in September. Yes, honey.
See, that's what I'm talking about. I think you're going to do great.
Thank you.
When you head off in November. On behalf of all Jamaicans, congratulations.
Thank you.
And we wish you all the best.
Thank
heading
you.
Into the Miss Universe pageant. I'm sure the folks who stages are very proud of you. Kyle and Mark are gritting their teeth off. Miss Universe Jamaica 2017.
Thank you.
My name is Davina Bennett. And is that your handle on social media?
Yes, that's Davina_Bennett_. It has been going up.
Yeah, how much you have now?
I have over 7,000, almost reached 8,000.
Yeah, man.
From 5. So I'm climbing.
Yeah, man, okay. You're getting there. We're rooting for you, Davina.
Thank you
for coming in this morning. This Universe Jamaica 2017, Davina Bennett. So, new clothes.